Hi, Speak Languages and Travel the World encourage you to learn languages and to travel around the world to broaden your horizons. So here I am in Bavaria, and I'd like to tell you the story of the maypole, which you can see here, which is a great tradition in many countries. And you can use this as a listening comprehension exercise, so you can write down what you've learned from this video. And at the same time, if you know of any traditions, you can also write those in the comments box below. So the maypole, which you can see here, is traditional in many, many countries. In England, we set up the maypole just in May, so it's set up provisionally, after which on particular days, I think it's the 1st of May, some dancers, all dressed nicely, are put on, the dancers who are dressed nicely dance around the maypole, but there are ribbons, I don't know if we can see them here. Yeah, there are ribbons that would come down the maypole, and as they're dancing around, some go clockwise and some go anti-clockwise. They would weave and therefore cover the maypole, practically wrap the maypole in woven ribbons. And it's very, very pretty because all the ribbons are different colours, and it's something to enjoy. But, sorry for the traffic, something which is only provisional, only in May. Instead, in Bavaria, the tradition of the maypole is very eradicated and quite different from other countries. So first of all, every village has a maypole, and this one is actually a little bit anomalous. It's in polling and it's quite tall. On the top you can see it has a weathercock. Well, I'm not sure if you can see it, but there's a weathercock turning in the wind. However, there's nothing else on the maypole. It's painted blue and white, which are the colours of the Bavarian state. And normally on the maypole there used to be, and some still have them, the different, let's say, professions, the different guilds were on a type of metal plaque, were stuck to the maypole, and that was just to show the different things that were in, the different professions that were in the town. So nowadays the maypole is something very important. Every so often it gets taken down, it stays up all year, and sometimes it's mended or they get a new one. So there are various problems. Let's imagine that the village needs a new maypole. So they usually get it and prepare it and leave it lying down until the 1st of May. But for the whole month of April, they have to guard it very closely because the other villages will try and steal the maypole. If they manage to steal the maypole, then the village who it was stolen from, the village which it was stolen from will have to have a big festival with beer and wurstel and pretzel and so on, and that's the only way you can get the maypole back. I know of one village who had to pay, and once they were celebrating, the maypole was stolen again during the celebrations. So they needed to re-celebrate again, and they guarded the maypole very well that time. So anyhow, on the 1st of May, you can see this maypole is set up, but it's not set up with a machine. It's a crane or something. It's set up manually. It's a big, big festival. So what they'll do is that they'll get so and so many men of the village to push it. They'll carry it along and they'll push it and then suddenly pull it up with ropes. It's a big festival with the town band and everybody watching, and it takes quite a while to get the maypole up. So once it's up, it's very difficult to pull it down again. It won't get stolen. It's only whilst it's down that it could get stolen. So then the maypole stays up for the whole year. And I think they steal the maypole, if I remember correctly, on the 30th of April, or they try to steal it. That's called Freinacht, when people are free to do what they like within limits. So I know that all my friends, they hide their garden furniture and bicycles, because it's not the first time that people have found their bicycles at the top of a tree, because they were allowed to do that on Freinacht, or their garden furniture moved quite far away, so they have to go and look for it. So that's the evening when one has to be very careful that nothing gets taken, because they're supposedly allowed to do things that are normally not allowed. I mean, not real stealing, just quite heavy jokes. Okay, so these were the two anecdotes I wanted to talk to you about: the tradition of the maypole in England and the tradition of the maypole in Bavaria. This is Kloster Polling that is ringing its bells, and is worth visiting if you're ever in Bavaria, not too far from Munich, south of Munich. And please write in the comments below if you understood the anecdotes and what you understood. If you have any other anecdotes about maypoles that I don't know of, that would be very interesting. I'm sure every country has different traditions. And if you found this video useful, don't forget to subscribe. And that's all for today. Bye.